pretty.
It's
just like here at the New York Aquarium, provide a safe space for people to come face to face with these amazing animals. Today, we're very excited to share with all of you some of their characteristics about the training we do here at the aquarium, as well as some things we can all do to help them in the wild. So let me so hopefully nobody will ever confuse them again. So the very first difference I'm going to talk about today is one of the smallest. It's right on the side of Townsend's head. I want everybody to try to find Townsend's ear. If you see a small little ear flap on the side of Townsend's head, kind of looks like a Tootsie Roll, you're looking at a sea lion. Flippers. Seals cannot do that. So when a seal moves across the land, they use their very strong stomach muscles, kind of looks like a bouncy ball, to behavior called undulating, where they will inchworm themselves across the land. Lions are marine mammals, so they live life both not only up here on land as you're seeing, but also in the water. So they definitely have some specialized adaptations for that specific environment. One of them is their eyesight. Sea lions have very excellent eyesight. They can see just as well underwater as they can above the water. Though some scientists do believe they're mostly colorblind, but they might be able to see shades of blues and greens, which makes a lot of sense if you think about their aquatic environment. Now, if you look closely at Aries' face, I'm going to talk about some of those adaptations. One of them being his whiskers. Now, sea lions do have whiskers, but they actually have a fancier name called vibrissae. And vibrissae can sense vibrations in the water. These really help sea lions know which way their fish is swimming. They can feel around in dark and murky waters. And if you watch Erie throughout his portion here, you may even notice when Sarah tosses fish to Erie, he can extend those whiskers all the way forward and feel exactly which way that fish is gonna fall. If you get a chance to look at any of our sea lions' mouths today, I want you to look at their teeth. Sea lions have 34 teeth. They're conical in shape, which basically is the shape of an upside-down ice cream cone. Now, they don't chew their fish. They do swallow all of their fish down whole, so those teeth are great at catching and grasping. And they even will develop a darker coloration as they age. They lack enamel, which is what we have that protects our teeth, so there's actually healthy bacteria that will grow on their teeth to protect theirs. Now with Townsend's head, we are talking about some of the differences between seals and sea lions. And one of those differences is how agile these animals are on land. While sea lions can be equally agile in the water with a behavior called bowing or porpoising, and we'd love to highlight this behavior for all of you with the help of Erie.
Thank you. It's so sad.